Haran, I know you're all about on edge and like real fast response time and everything, and you told me you have a perfect demo to show me that. I want to know more.
Oh, awesome. So, Frank, thanks for having me on the show. So, as we know, Azure Edge Zones are a lot of flexible, low latency solutions to be built and deployed to Azure Edge Zones. With carriers such as Verizon or AT&T, you can also deploy them out to private edge zones. It's really kind of cool when you start going down this. However, when you start going down this rabbit hole of how do I get better performance, you start to have to look at other things like your tech stack. So I did this research recently, and I was very, very shocked at seeing the word come up over and over again, gRPC. gRPC is a high-performance remote procedure call framework with bidirectional streaming using HTTP version 2 for its transport. You can send and receive information synchronously, asynchronously, or via streams. There's really large companies using this, people like Netflix, Square, Cisco, Dropbox, and Google. And the cool thing about it is that it's built into .NET. It's actually been around for a while. Since .NET Core 3, we've had support for this. Now with ASP.NET 6 and all the performance improvements we see there, bringing gRPC in, it's an amazing story to kind of see. So I built a demo real quick to show you this off. And I do have Visual Studio for the Mac up and running on my computer. If you want to take a look at it, I can show you some code.
Yeah, let's look at it.
Excellent. So everything starts in ASP.NET, and this is on the Mac, by the way, but .NET runs everywhere, so it's awesome. So I've got my program, that CS file, up and running here. This is for ASP.NET, and you can see here, this is no smoke and mirrors. This is the standard setup of ASP.NET Core. There's a couple things here. I'm set up Kestrel. This should look normal to .NET developers. Here's our magical line. This goes through and adds gRPC service and gets it set up to run. Okay, this reads in my configuration and sets up my database connection because in this demo, we're not going to just look at mock data. We're going to look at real data from a database server because that's where we can start to see latency and see how we can improve on things. So this is boilerplate.NET code here. We have a builder. We're mapping up a service. And then you can see here, this is if somebody goes to this in your browser, your regular browser, this route basically will tell them, hey, you can't use a browser. You have to use a client. And that's how gRPC works. Even though it's using HTTP version 2, you have to use a client to talk to it. Okay. So let's take a look at really what is gRPC? How do you set up like a protocol file? So you can see here, this is a protocol file and what it looks like. Now, I'm going to help some C# developers out here. So, one, the format could look kind of crazy, but if you look here, I have links to the Microsoft documentation that explains the entire format for you. However, if you look at that word service, this is a contract. So that in C# would mean the word interface. If we look at that word RPC, that's basically defining like a function or a method call. So this file, we're going to define an interface that basically will get auto-generated an abstract class for us, and it's going to generate some methods based on these RPCs. Now, this right here, these particular things request for the document and the quest, these are what they call messages. And these are just like structs or classes or data classes in C#. And when you define these, it's going to auto-generate all the C# code for you. How crazy is that? We literally are getting code generation where once I build this file and I click the build button, it's going to generate code for me. That's pretty amazing.
That's
So
really amazing.
it
Oh,
is.
and Aaron, like when we were chatting earlier, you mentioned also the name. Like you have a variable at the top, and you say that it's better when you don't have the any underscore or dash for like.
Correct.
That was
So
a
there
good
is.
gotcha. I didn't know that, so.
Yeah, so up in your namespace here, you really have to watch out for that. It needs to match your C# project, and I highly recommend staying away from things like dashes and underscores because it could kind of screw up the auto-generated code sometimes. And so just watch your naming conventions, and it's all explained in Microsoft Docs, but absolutely don't forget that part because it'll get you, it'll throw you for a little loop a few
Yeah,
times.
you could lose precious seconds or minutes or hours searching for that.
Absolutely. So once we have this protocol file, what ends up happening is I do a build one time and it generates me an abstract class. So then all I have to do is implement that abstract class. So here I have my implementation. It's right here. You see, this is the name of the class that the compiler automatically built for me, part of code generation. And you see here, it's called quest service. We saw that earlier in our protocol buffer file. That's what it looked like. And here's the methods that I defined there in the RPC. So here's a get quest. Here's a get quests, and it takes on that same quest request that we had there earlier that was a message. And then this is just standard C# code that I implement to talk to my database. So with that, let's take a look at the client talking to the server so we can kind of see what does this kind of look like. So in the client code, I do want to show you one thing here. So inside of our CS proj file, when we implement the client, there is no code generation for you out of the box without you having to add an entry into the CS proj file. Okay. So, and this is only on VS Code, on VS Visual Studio for Mac and PC. If you add in, if you copy this file in, it will make this entry for you. However, when you look at the file definition here, you need to make sure on the client, very specifically, it says the word client instead of server. Otherwise, the code that it generates will be the wrong code. So that's a gotcha also. It's also explained really well in the docs. But if we look at this, the really cool thing is that all the code to talk to the server is generated for you then once you do a build. You see here, here's my channel, and that's how I connect to my server. Now I'm going to run this locally so we can kind of see this in action. And then what ends up happening is that once you connect to this channel and your client code, I'm just going to use my little pull down list here to see all my methods. I'm just going to go into the get quests. You'll see here the line of code to do this is just basically one line of code right here. Get quest async. I add a timeout and that's it. It's all said and done. So let's take a look at the client running real quick here. I'm going to go to my command prompt and just do .NET run. And the client should come up and running here. Now, the first time it runs, it's going to be slow because of the fact that it takes the handshake process. So you see here at in the information window, it says 170 milliseconds. However, after you do your very first refresh, what you're going to find 19 milliseconds. That is lightning fast. And this is pulling That's data fast. Live from the database. And I can then go through and look at all the different records. And it's literally like instantaneously 19 milliseconds. I've seen it as low as like 9 to 10 milliseconds. This is amazing pieces of technology that you can use. And the cool thing is you're reusing all that .NET, all the C# skills you have. And because this is just ASP.NET, really easy to deploy into Azure. Really, really easy to deploy into Azure. So that's gRPC. I highly recommend if anybody's looking at edge computing, looking at Azure Edge, take a look at this as maybe it's a better tool than using something like REST APIs or things like GraphQL. Those are great tools also, but this is another tool to add to your toolbox.
Yeah, it always depends also what's your scenario. If like second, like if the response time has like a major impact or like if, you know, it's not that.
Absolutely. Companies like gaming companies, people in the financial industry and healthcare services and stuff, these industries really are looking for those latency things. And services like gRPC could really give you a big performance boost on that.
Wonderful. So all the link you provide will be in the show note. So down below, go there. All the link are there. But now Excellent. Let's go see the chat and answer a few questions. Thank you,
Aaron. Sounds great. Thank you, Frank.